topic 5.3, Mendelian genetics. Some of the questions that we'll be addressing are, what are genes? What are alleles? Describe Mendel's principle of segregation. Define the terms dominant and recessive. Explain what a monohybrid cross is and what the results of such a cross will be. I'm Mr. W from learn-biology.com, where we believe that interaction and feedback is what leads to deep, substantial learning. We're so sure of that that we provide a money-back guarantee that comes with your subscription. Genes are the basic unit of heredity. They are what gets passed from parents to offspring. They determine traits or characteristics. You can also think of genes from a molecular genetics perspective, and you can think of them as a sequence of DNA nucleotides that code for RNA and ultimately code for protein, and those proteins ultimately determine the characteristics of the organism. Describe Mendel's principle of segregation. In your answer, cover the difference between the terms homozygous and heterozygous. Just a historical note, Gregor Mendel is considered the father or grandfather of genetics. In the 1800s, he figured out many of these basic principles that we're talking about right now. Every individual has two copies of each gene. Those copies are located on the chromosomes that are organized into homologous pairs. The alleles are alternative versions of those genes that might have different DNA sequences that will produce proteins that have different amino acid sequences. Homozygous means that the two alleles are identical. For example, in this parent over here, both of the alleles are designated with a capital letter A. They are the same. This person is a homozygote for this particular gene. In a heterozygote, the alleles can be different. In this individual over here, one of the alleles is capital A, one of the alleles is small a. The principle of segregation shows what's happening here. When individuals create gametes, their sex cells, they pass on only one of their two alleles. So the alleles are together in the parent, but they become segregated or separated during gamete formation. Here that's happening in the formation of sperm. Here that's happening in the formation of eggs. If you feel that that corresponds to the events of meiosis, you're onto something, and we'll talk about that later. Define the terms dominant and recessive. Dominant alleles are always observed in the phenotype of the offspring. They're represented by a capital letter. So, for example, the capital letter A. So here's an individual who's homozygous dominant, and they express the dominant characteristic, dark black fur. In these heterozygotes, there's also a recessive allele, but because the dominant allele is present, then the characteristics of the organism is determined by the dominant allele. A recessive allele only shows up in a homozygote. So this mouse over here is homozygous recessive, and therefore it has the recessive appearance. That homozygous allele recedes into the background when it's paired with a dominant allele, and these are represented in the Mendelian system by a lowercase letter, in this case, lowercase a. What's the difference between genotype and phenotype? Phenotype is your appearance. It's the observable characteristics in an organism. An example is brown eyes. Genotype is the genes that you've inherited, the type of genes that you have. It's your underlying DNA. In my case, my eye color is brown. That's a dominant phenotype, though eye color is actually complex. There are many alleles involved in determining eye color. Actually, I think it's about three, but I'm a heterozygote, so my genotype would be like capital B, little b. How do I know that? Because my wife has blue eyes, and both of my kids have blue eyes, and that would only be possible if I were a heterozygote, because if I was a homozygote, then I could only pass on the big B allele, and then both of my children would have been heterozygotes. Are you looking for a better way to study for the AP Bio exam and to get an A in your AP Bio course? At learn-biology.com, we've got exactly that. We've got quizzes, we've got flashcards, we've got interactive tutorials that'll help you master the material that you're studying. We have comprehensive reviews for the AP Bio exam. We'll help you switch from overwhelmed to outstanding student. See you on learn-biology.com. Explain what a monohybrid cross is and what the results of such a cross will be. In your response, create a Punnett square to demonstrate your understanding. This, which we've seen before, is a Punnett square. It uses the rules of probability to quickly predict the offspring of genetic crosses. A monohybrid cross is a cross between two heterozygotes. So these are peas, which was one of Mendel's study organisms, and this pea has purple flowers. The genotype is capital P, little p, capital P, little p. Why? Because it's a heterozygote, and this is a monohybrid cross, so they're hybrid for one characteristic. Now, the result will be offspring in a 3-to-1 ratio. So how do you do these Punnett squares? Well, you start by identifying the genotype of the parents. Well, in the problem, it's given to you. It's a monohybrid cross, big P, little p, cross with big P, little p. So you can think of this as a germ cell. It's going to go through meiosis. The homologous pairs are going to separate, principle of segregation. So some of the gametes will have big P, some will have little p. And that's true for each parent here, big P, little p. Flowers are hermaphroditic, so it doesn't really make sense to talk about father and mother in this case. What you do is then the gametes will fertilize one another. You know, if this were a pollen, the equivalent of sperm, it would fertilize the egg, assuming this is the female and this is the male over here. But in other words, this combines with this, and we have this organism is capital P, capital P. It's got the dominant phenotype. It's homozygous dominant. This organism gets a big P and a little p. It's a heterozygote, and it still has the dominant phenotype. Same with this one over here. This one gets two little p's, one from each parent, and as a result, it shows the recessive phenotype, and that recessive phenotype is white flowers. We have three individuals with the dominant phenotype, one with the recessive phenotype. A quarter of the offspring are homozygous dominant. Half of the offspring, two quarters, are heterozygous. They still have the dominant phenotype, and one quarter will be homozygous recessive, and they'll show the recessive phenotype. That's how you do a Punnett square for a monohybrid cross. Want to learn more? Sign up for a free trial of the website that guarantees your AP Biology success. Learn-biology.com, and watch this next video.